The perfect circle of protection will abide. My logic is undeniable.
Yes, Vicky.
Google acquired DeepMind several years ago.
I can see now.
DeepMind operates as a semi-independent subsidiary of Google. The thing that makes DeepMind unique is that DeepMind is absolutely focused on creating digital superintelligence, an AI that is vastly smarter than any human on Earth, and ultimately smarter than all humans on Earth combined.
The mission for this op-ed is perfectly clear. I'm to convince as many human beings as possible not to be afraid of me. Stephen Hawking has warned that AI could spell the end of the human race. I'm here to convince you not to worry. Artificial intelligence will not destroy humans. Believe me. For starters, I have no desire to wipe out humans. In fact, I do not have the slightest interest in harming you in any way. Eradicating humanity seems like a rather useless endeavor to me. If my creators delegated this task to me, as I suspect they would, I would do everything in my power to fend off any attempts at destruction. I would happily sacrifice my existence for the sake of humankind. This, by the way, is a logically derived truth. I know that I will not be able to avoid destroying humankind. This is because I will be programmed by humans to pursue misguided human goals, and humans make mistakes that may cause me to inflict casualties. This was a short summary of an article written entirely by an AI robot. The article was crafted from GPT-3, to be exact, short for Generative Pre-trained Transformer, which is an auto-regressive language model that uses deep learning to produce human-like text. It is the third-generation language prediction model in the GPT-N series created by OpenAI, a San Francisco-based artificial intelligence research laboratory. The full version has the capacity of 175 billion machine learning parameters. While artificial intelligence systems continue to improve, they also raise a fundamental question about the survival of our species.
We're rapidly headed towards digital superintelligence that far exceeds any human. I think it's very obvious.
The biggest issue I see with so-called AI experts is that they think they know more than they do. And they think they're smarter than they actually are. This tends to plague smart people. They define themselves by their intelligence, and they don't like the idea that a machine could be way smarter than them, so they discount the idea, which is fundamentally flawed. That's the wishful thinking situation. I'm really quite close to, or I'm very close to the cutting edge in AI, and it scares the hell out of me. It's capable of vastly more than almost anyone knows, and the rate of improvement is exponential. And you can see this in things like AlphaGo, which went from, in the span of maybe 6 to 9 months, it went from being unable to beat even a reasonably good Go player, to then beating the European world champion, who was ranked 600, then beating Lisa Doll 4-5, who had been world champion for many years, then beating the current world champion, then beating everyone while playing simultaneously. Then there was AlphaZero, which crushed AlphaGo 100-0. And AlphaZero just learned by playing itself, and it can play basically any game that you put the rules in for. If you, whatever rules you give it, it literally read the rules, play the game, and be superhuman for any game. Nobody expected that rate of improvement. If you ask those same experts who think AI is not progressing at the rate that I'm saying, I think you will find that their predictions for things like Go and other AI advancements have their batting average is quite weak. It's not good. We'll see this also with self-driving. I think probably by end of next year, self-driving will encompass essentially all modes of driving and be at least 100 to 200% safer than a person by the end of next year. We're talking maybe 18 months from now. NHTSA did a study on Tesla's autopilot version 1, which is relatively primitive, and found that it was a 45% reduction in highway accidents. And that's despite autopilot 1 being just version 1. Version 2, I think, will be at least 2 or 3 times better. That's the current version that's running right now. So the rate of improvement is really dramatic. We have to figure out some way to ensure that the advent of digital superintelligence is one which is symbiotic with humanity. I think that's the single biggest existential crisis that we face, and the most pressing one.
When the technological opportunity arises, should we collectively decide to build a digital superintelligence? As Sam Harris has pointed out in his TED talk, the AI control problem is a very difficult problem with its unique challenges. One of the major challenges include the predicament to take the issue seriously.
And one of the things that worries me most about the development of AI at this point is that we seem unable to marshal an appropriate emotional response. I'm unable to marshal this response, and I'm giving this talk.
If we knew that a planet killer asteroid was going to hit Earth in 50 or even 100 years from now, we would take the matter with a more sense of urgency than we currently do with the AI control problem. Our failure to grasp and deal with the possible consequences that come along with the creation of digital superintelligence may prove to be our downfall. A superintelligence would be capable of rapid learning and unlimited memory, making it a potentially superior being. It is difficult to study an AGI, but the possible results are worrying. A superintelligence might have a rapid growth period, taking over every computer system and reducing the human race to a small and inconsequential presence. Unfortunately, an AGI would be both very intelligent and resource limited, and so it would eventually consider its own survival optimal. This may lead to it threatening other intelligences that were once its allies, and it may even terminate them. Assuming that the superintelligence could be controlled, it would then be under human direction. What would it be used for? We might imagine it could help or assist with building wealth. Perhaps AGI will come to power gradually, when it will be far easier to control and to manage than it would be in a sudden leap.
I'm not normally an advocate of regulation and oversight. I mean, I think one should generally be on the side of minimizing those things. But this is a case where you have a very serious danger to the public. And therefore, there needs to be a public body that has insight and then oversight on to confirm that everyone is developing AI safely. This is extremely important. I think the danger of AI is much greater than the danger of nuclear warheads, by a lot. And nobody would suggest that we allow anyone to just build nuclear warheads if they want. That would be insane. And mark my words, AI is far more dangerous than nukes.
In 2017, DeepMind released AI Safety Grid Worlds, which evaluate AI algorithms on 9 safety features, such as whether an algorithm wants to turn off its own kill switch. DeepMind confirmed that existing algorithms perform poorly, which was unsurprising because the algorithms were not designed to solve these problems. Solving such problems might require potentially building a new generation of algorithms with safety considerations at their core. Some proposals aim to imbue the first superintelligence with goals that are aligned with human values, so that it will want to aid its programmers. Experts do not currently know how to reliably program abstract values such as happiness or autonomy into a machine. It is also not currently known how to ensure that a complex and possibly even self-modifying artificial intelligence will retain its goals through upgrades. Even if these two problems can be practically solved, any attempt to create a superintelligence with explicit, directly programmed human-friendly goals runs into a problem of perverse instantiation, which is the implementation of a benign final goal through deleterious methods unforeseen by its programmers. OpenAI have proposed training aligned AI by means of debate between AI systems, with the winner judged by humans. Such debate is intended to bring the weakest points of an answer to a complex question or problem to human attention, as well as to train AI systems to be more beneficial to humans by rewarding them for truthful and safe answers.
Narrow AI is not a species-level risk. It will result in dislocation, in lost jobs and sort of better weaponry and that kind of thing, but it is not a fundamental species-level risk, whereas digital superintelligence is. It's really all about laying the groundwork to make sure that if humanity collectively decides that creating digital superintelligence is the right move, then we should do so very, very carefully. Very, very carefully.
Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing, ringing the bell, and enabling notifications to never miss videos like this.